The comparisons to Star Trek aside, a lot of Star Trek alumni have been involved in this show, and I would imagine that some conversations have taken place on how to maintain the Orville's brand, the Orville's identity, as opposed to just making another Star Trek. Has that been a challenge to find that balance between the homage to Trek and doing your own thing?
Not at all, because the show that Seth created when we came aboard, he'd already written the pilot, and it already felt like its own thing, which is to say, definitely an homage to the genre of a space exploration show set on a ship. Not a parody at all, not a satire, but with characters that are more accessible and down to earth, something of a workplace comedy in some ways. But at the same time, with the main emphasis being on the dramatic storytelling, it was always, I felt anyway, its own thing from right out of the gate.
Yeah, I mean, we certainly have discussions about stories that that might feel similar to a Star Trek episode, but again, our characters take it somewhere else. Or if we feel it's too similar, we don't do it. But it's really about the stories that show off our characters and their relationships, which is not Star Trek. There's nothing Star Trek about our characters.
So moving to Hulu has done what for the show in terms of what kinds of stories you can tell, the way you can tell those stories? Has very much changed in the approach to production for season three as opposed to the other two seasons?
We'll certainly let John talk to that, I think.
Well, yeah, I think on two fronts, the guys can talk about sort of the writing of it, but you can tell bigger stories. Most of our shows are at least an hour, so that's already 20 minutes more than you would get on network, and some of them are closer to an hour and a half. So you can imagine they're virtually like films. And so you can explore a story a little more. You can get into more detail. You can have, you know, two stories going at the same time and they both get good screen time. And then visually, we've stepped it up to match that, you know, so because it feels like you're watching a little bit of a movie, it truly is cinematic. You've seen it in a trailer. Yeah, I think you've seen some episodes. You see it right away. And so we've upgraded the ship. The visual effects is, I can easily say, some of the best on television right now, without a doubt. Some of the best on television. So, you know, we just build it all up knowing that we had that space to do it.
And it started in the writer's room with not being confined, as John said, by a network running time. You were able to sort of follow the story. Where do you want this story to go? And not feel limited. And Hulu definitely provides that kind of freedom. And Disney and Hulu provide a lot of resources so that we can get it done.
So without getting into spoiler territory, what kind of things should we expect coming into season three? You're talking about bigger stories, more character arcs. We're going to see returning characters, guest stars coming back. What are we in store for?
All of what you just said.
Oh, exactly. Already.
It's an emotional roller coaster ride. Yeah. It's cinematic, and it's, as John says, it looks cinematic. The episodes play like movies, which they essentially are. But man, I think the thing that I'm most proud of in some ways is what an emotional impact this season has. It's a really moving, a lot of really moving things happen.
And it's still the format, still self-contained adventures each week with a running thread. We've in previous seasons, we've always had sort of running threads of relationships throughout the season, but still, if you turn on an episode of Orville, you're going to get a complete adventure, and you're also going to get an exploration of our characters, and we get into depth with our depths with these characters this season that fans of the show will really appreciate and new fans will also enjoy. So that's the other piece of it.
All right. We're looking forward to it. Season three of the Orville. Gentlemen, thanks very much for taking time to talk to us.
Thanks, Jason.
You're watching Sci-Fi for Me TV.